Data recovery can be expensive. However, losing files and records that are irreplaceable can be devastating. This tutorial will explain what a file backup is and how it can keep your data safe. We will also explain two different backup types and provide some tips that can help you manage your backup strategy. You can think of your computer as a file cabinet. And just as in a file cabinet, the files located on your computer's hard drive are what is referred to as stored. When files are in a stored state, you have ready access and may modify the files as you wish. And just as in a file cabinet, the files are not especially protected. When the original files that are on your computer are copied to a second hard drive, they are referred to as backed up. You can think of a backup drive as a safe. If the original files are lost or damaged, you can restore them with the backed up copies. Creating copies of your files and putting them in a safe place provides a higher level of protection than just storing them on your computer. There are two types of backups. The first type is the file and folder backup, which can include all the files and folders on your computer's hard drive, with the exception of hidden and operating system files. The second type of backup is called a drive image backup. A drive image backup is a complete copy of your computer's hard drive, which not only includes all files and folders, but hidden files, operating system files, and all partitions that are contained on your hard drive. The following are suggestions for backing up your data and keeping it safe. All mechanical devices can fail. If you want to make sure that important data stays safe, Seagate recommends making at least two backup copies of your files. Use two backup devices and keep one in a safe, secure place. Depending on the data you are backing up and your particular circumstances, you should consider keeping the second copy in a different physical location. Backup programs can compress and encrypt the files being backed up. Backup financial and email files according to your software's requirements. These types of files may need to be imported instead of simply restored. After creating an initial drive image backup, update the image every time there is an operating system update. This way you can reinstall the latest version of the operating system or select an earlier version if you wish. Give your backups a meaningful name. This practice comes in handy when you need to find a particular file. Use removable drives such as a USB or networked drives for backup devices. Using a separate partition on your storage drive or a slave drive which is mounted in your computer defeats the purpose of a data backup. Run a diagnostic on your backup device periodically. Staying informed of any drive issue can save you from losing your files. Our final tip is to include your backup drives in your antivirus scan. If an infected file were to be backed up before it was quarantined, there's a good chance that you can infect the computer when the file is restored. This concludes the Seagate Backup and Best Practices tutorial. Please visit the Seagate website to see our line of USB and network backup devices. You can also download copies of our backup software from the Seagate site. Use Seagate Dashboard and a Seagate USB or networked device to create a file and folder type backup plan, and use Seagate Disk Wizard to create drive image backups. For more information on using either of the Seagate backup software applications, please see our support tutorials and knowledge base articles.